This is Spoken Gospel. We're dedicated to seeing Jesus in all of Scripture. In each episode, we see what's happening in a biblical text and how it sheds light on Jesus and his gospel. Let's jump in. Israel is under attack, and the songwriter Asaph asks God to rescue his weak nation from their strong enemies. Israel's enemies aren't just strong, they are vicious. They're like animals grunting, snorting, and pawing the earth. For years, they have plotted for this moment. They have gathered an axis of kings and nations to finally wipe Israel off the map. A new coalition of Israel's historic enemies, stretching all the way back to the beginning of the Bible, have gathered against them. And for Asaph, this isn't just another geopolitical battle. It's representative of a spiritual battle. The unstoppable forces of death and evil are marching toward Israel. Israel's chances of survival are slim, but the songwriter knows the odds are not an obstacle for God. Throughout their history, God has always used the weak to topple the strong. He remembers when the Canaanite general Sisera oppressed Israel under the wheels of his 900 iron chariots, and how God raised up a woman named Jael who, with a tent peg and a bowl of milk, crushed Sisera's skull and ended his regime. Asaph also remembers how the uncountable armies of Midian fell to Israel's reluctant leader, Gideon, and how Gideon forced Midian's surrender and delivered Israel from their cruelty, armed with nothing but some trumpets and a few fragile jars. God is a God who humiliates the strong by using the weak. So Asaph asks God to turn fortified nations into tumbleweed, to make powerful armies like dry wood before a fire, and to expose proud kings as nothing but tiny ships caught in a hurricane. The songwriter doesn't just want his enemies defeated, he wants them shamed and humiliated. He wants their power brought down by what they least expect. He wants them shamed so that they will know that God rules over the whole earth. The people of God will always be under attack. Jesus promised that this would be the case. But the good news is that while our enemies might feel too powerful to topple, God promises to humiliate the strong by conquering them with weakness. While the earth throughout all time has gathered its hordes and armed their militaries, God sent a child to defeat them. Unlike the armies of this world, God disarmed himself of his cosmic power and became a human named Jesus, who was born to die. Like Jael with her humble tent peg and Gideon with his fragile jars, God used Jesus's death to humiliate an empire. Not Canaan or Midian or Rome, but the spiritual threats of death and evil that have always cruelly oppressed and killed God's people. Jesus humiliated death not by avoiding it, but by absorbing all the fury death and the grave could muster, only to rise from his tomb. God disarmed the ultimate empire, not in an explosive display of geopolitical power, but by a powerless Jewish carpenter. In Jesus, death and those who wield it aren't just defeated, they're humiliated. The world and all that God has planned for it belongs to the humble, the broken, and the poor. Jesus' death has secured this truth forever. A new age of eternal, victorious life has dawned, and the powers of our world can do nothing to stop it. And if God was not ashamed to become a child, he will not be ashamed to include weak and humble people like us in his kingdom either. So I pray that the Holy Spirit will open your eyes to see the God who rules over all the earth. And may you see Jesus as the one who died to shame the strong and include the weak in his kingdom.